There are an estimated 21 million people trapped in slavery, and almost the population of New Zealand are victims of forced commercial sexual exploitation. Tearfund work across the spectrum to try and combat this and the damage it does to those affected. Now, the Tearfund Poverty Cycle is a way to raise money and to help their cause. And to tell us more, please welcome to the cafe Petra Bagust, Edu Drent and John Watson.
Yes! Welcome,
guys. Welcome. John,
Stella.
Let's start with you. Those are some pretty horrendous statistics that I just went through then. So what's Tearfund doing to help the victims?
It is pretty horrendous. We work across the spectrum, so in prevention, trying to prevent the poorest and some of the most vulnerable people in communities in Southeast Asia from being trafficked, so tricked or coerced into exploitation, either labour exploitation or forced commercial sexual exploitation.
So how do you do that?
Well, you do it through some economic empowerment, because the most vulnerable people are the poorest people, and they're easier to trick. And we also work in prosecution, so investigating the criminal networks behind the crime. And then finally in rehabilitation, so walking them on a journey of kind of healing and hope again.
That's a lot on.
It is.
And
Petra and Edu, before we go any further, what drew you to this particular charity, out of curiosity?
The average age of a person trafficked is 12, and my daughter, when I got involved with Tearfund, was around about that age. And it's just sort of like, as a mother, you feel like these are children who are getting tricked because they're families are hungry often,
right,
and they've got nobody to speak for them, and I felt as a woman in this country I wanted to speak up.
Yeah, I was in LA 5 years ago, and I watched a documentary with my wife Mandy, and at the time it just completely broke me. I remember sitting on this couch just crying, bawling, and just uncontrollably. And since then I've had a couple of kids of my own, and so now when I look at my son and I go, oh wow, if you were that child in that place, what would I give or what would I do to make sure that you can get free and see, and live a better life? Mm. And so for me, that's the thing that really, every time I talk about it, that connects me back to the cause. You know, when I see my son and my daughter, I'm like, man, that's what it's about. That's freedom.
If these were our kids, how would you move heaven and earth.
Yeah. And last year, you both were in Thailand and Cambodia, weren't you, with Tearfund, looking at what goes on. And I hear there were some pretty emotional moments.
Yeah,
there
absolutely.
Some ugly crying went on, eh?
Yeah, lots of ugly crying.
Because you actually see people being bought and sold. You see people thought of as commodities, and they don't have freedom, and they don't have hope. And so we were just like amazed at the work that Tearfund's partners on the ground are doing.
Yeah, and I think part of the crying was actually you see the bad places as well, but then you see the good and the hope that's restored in these people, and the stories of the survivors who have come out and on the other end and living incredible lives. So yeah, for me it was like seeing both was really awesome.
So now there is a way New Zealanders locally right here can help directly, John. So what is going on with this cycle?
So on August 26th at Ardmore Airport, you can register at povertycycle.org.nz to take part in this charity cycle race.
Super fun. It's absolutely awesome. Get on your bike. You can be on a stationary bike.
You can do a stationary bike, your team. And for people sitting at home that think, I don't want to take part in the cycle, you can do a virtual event. So that's where you pick anything at all in the month of August.
Give up a coffee, walk around the block, anything.
Wine.
And spread the word to encourage your friends and family to raise money to help you.
And for people who don't want to do it, they can sponsor us. You can go on there.
Yeah.
Povertycycle.org.
Like Mike said, he's going to sponsor me.
So you've got a few celebs involved with this. John, who's involved? So obviously these two.
Absolutely these two.
Shorty Street Stars.
Big draw.
Shorty Street Stars, Amanda Billings. We've got a guy who rode the cycle in the Team New Zealand in their victory.
You've got one of those.
We do.
One of the cyclists. That's pretty impressive. Do you need to have, if you want to enter a team yourself or go individually, do you need to have much skill or just be able to ride around a bike?
No. It's a pretty easy course, 25Ks around twice, lots of marshals. I was a brand newbie 3 years ago and I did it on my town and country that I ride the kids to school in.
Yeah.
They said to me, that's the wrong helmet, you've got a peak, you look so uncool. Take the basket off. But it was great, it was safe and good fun.
But I think the thing is that anyone can get involved in whatever capacity. They can either ride the full race or they can sponsor someone, or they can give like a copy for a week,
bike,
or stationary bike. And that's the thing, like everyone can do something, what I mean? Doesn't mean like small or big.
And that's the thing. And Kiwis are quite good at actually, getting off their bums and doing something to help, because they want to help. Okay, we've talked a bit about what goes on overseas. Can I talk a bit more about what happens locally? Because I know that some of this money does help local events that Tearfund do. John?
That's right, yeah. So we, as well as the money funding some of our anti-trafficking work, we also, some of the money goes to Brothers in Arms and 24/7 Youth Work, who are two fantastic organisations based here in New Zealand that work with some of New Zealand's most vulnerable youth too.
Right.
So how much did you raise? Because you've been doing it, what, for 6 years now?
We have, yeah, we have. So last year we raised 128,000.
So we've got to raise more than that this year. Yeah.
Well, the target this year...
200,000!
Well, you know, we're guaranteed.
Oh, he's rolling out 100,000.
New Zealand, can we do it? 50,000 right here. We're on our way there, fantastic.
Yeah. Okay, so is it too late to ask for us to enter, though?
No.
No, absolutely not.
It's... I mean, us as in collective New Zealand.
We would love to have you on the team. We've got one space.
Have you really?
Yeah.
Do. Oh, okay.
Really?
Yeah, I'll be into that.
That'd
actually
be great.
Yeah, for sure.
The last time I rode, I had to double my son behind me on a road in Vietnam, and that was interesting going.
That's a piece
so there's
of
no
cake.
Doubling in this?
No doubling. Yeah. So you're in as well. Cool. Great. You guys are
getting full. You've got a
team.
Nice. Okay, now this is good because it is helping, and let's face it, you know, the world always needs a little bit of extra help. And if you're not in Auckland, you can't be part of the actual event. There are plenty of ways you can get involved. So make sure you do. We're all going to get involved, so
awesome.
We challenge you at home as well to get involved. Are you up for it?
Yeah, absolutely.
I know, we've just backed ourselves.
Yes.
And if you want to get on your bike and be part of the Tearfund Poverty Cycle to help the fight against human trafficking, you can go to the website povertycycle.org.nz today and get fundraising. Yeah. Thank you so much, guys.
Yeah. Thank you for coming.
We'll see you soon, no doubt.